One, go.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Mysteries Explained with Becky and Will.
Hello.
Will just walked in the door. I thought I was going to have to start the show without you.
Could have.
I was going to panic. No.
I know you would have panicked.
Nah, I think I could have handled it without you for like a minute or two.
As long as you had something to talk about other than yourself. No.
You're not nice.
I know. I love you.
Sure you do. Well, later on tonight, we are bringing in another tour company, Gavest Tours. I think that's going to be really interesting to talk to them.
It's always interesting.
Because of the fact that we learn about other tour companies, and this is what we do.
Yeah.
So it's always a nice thing to be able to get some new, fresh ideas, see what their tours are like, and...
Yes, we're going to steal their ideas.
We're going to steal their ideas. But as long as we're not doing it in the same town, I think that would be okay.
I think they're all pretty much the same.
I don't know. We've done a couple of them. There's some different things on each tours, but...
Basically, they're all the same, though. Different stories, different locations, different theatrics.
We'll see.
Yeah.
Maybe they'll have some fresh ideas that we don't have.
Hand out popcorn.
Hand out popcorn. Hey, I was on a tour that actually handed out marshmallows and claimed it was ghost poop.
Did you eat it?
Well, yeah, it was marshmallows.
No, it wasn't. It was ghost poop. You ate poo-poo.
It was marshmallows, and they were yummy.
You ate ghost poo-poo.
Oh, my goodness. Whatever.
You said it was yummy. You're disgusting.
Oh, my God. Whatever. So we have... a ton to talk about, though, before we bring on our guest.
That's a lot.
Yeah, a lot.
Can you handle all that?
I don't know. Can you?
I don't know. Have you been working out? Because that ton's pretty heavy.
Oh, my God. Whatever. Oh, my gosh, Will. Don't make me slap you.
Well, something other than the finger. That's new.
Well, if you prefer the finger, you know, I'm so used to giving that one.
I know you like the finger.
Anyway, last week we didn't have a guest, unfortunately.
Yeah, faked a car accident.
He didn't fake a car accident, but he did get into a car accident. So we will be rescheduling him in the future. We're completely booked for the next, I don't even know how long. So we will book him in the future. We just don't know when. We have another group that was a couple weeks back that my computer crashed and we didn't get to have them on, and we're going to rebook them. So we have two guests from the past month, I think it is, that we have to rebook, but it'll be further into the future. Last week we did talk a little bit about some stuff going on, updated some people. We even got more updates now. If you did not tune. See, I can talk. I really can. If you did not tune in last week, you missed some of our announcements. But don't worry. We're going to talk about them again. Number one, if you're seeing the show right now, you're seeing that it's Mysteries Explained with Becky and Will. Especially if you're in Spreaker, you're going to see that it only says Becky and Will now. Because of the fact that Dave did leave us.
Boo.
Yeah, we're not happy about it, but we wish him the best of luck. We're going to miss him. But he did leave us, so it's just Will and I now. So you get to hear husband and wife, you know, bicker back and forth and all that lovely stuff.
Which makes it so much more exciting.
So, yeah, you get to put up with a husband and wife team now. But... other than that, we have so much going on. Like, a ton of things going on. And we start with the fact that we announced on our Facebook page a bunch of new events that we're doing. Things we've never done before and some things that we have. And one of the first things we're going to be doing, though, which hasn't been announced, so everyone's basically hearing this for the very first time, is that we are going to start doing some live YouTube videos.
That's going to get scary, trust me.
Yeah, especially with the one that we're planning on doing this Saturday.
Oh, I was just talking about myself being ill.
Oh, is that it?
Yeah.
All right. Well, the live YouTube videos, we are going to try. Now, we can't guarantee we can go live at all these locations because of the fact that it depends on our reception, which a lot of times sucks, by the way.
You know, there's supposed to not be a problem with that stuff anymore. We're supposed to be global. Everybody should be able to be in touch, even if you're in the middle of the woods. But no, it's false advertising.
No. Yeah. So depending on reception is whether or not we will actually go live on YouTube. If we can't go live, we will still be recording and then putting it on YouTube when we have reception. We're going to test it out this Saturday. I'm hoping we can actually go live.
I think we can.
I hope so. I know when we get further into the building, sometimes our reception kind of sucks. So I'm hoping if we use their Wi-Fi, we'll be good.
Maybe it's the spirits.
It could be. I don't know. But we are going back to Slaughterhouse.
Woohoo!
And, wow, you were actually loud with that woohoo. I'm sure everyone heard that.
Anybody listening?
I don't know.
Type, hey, y'all, if you are.
Well, they could be listening through iHeart or Spotify. They may not be in, you know, on Spreaker. If they are in Spreaker, we do encourage them to go to the chat room, though.
And if you're not in Spreaker, we encourage you to download that. Open up that page. That way you can listen on one page and communicate in the chat room on the other.
Only because you just like to make it, you know.
Difficult?
Well, no, you just like to make sure people are listening.
You're right, I do.
Maybe they just don't want to talk to us. You ever think of that? Maybe they want to listen but not talk. That's possible.
That's boring.
Well, you know, some people are like that. Some people don't like to get in chat rooms.
We like to be interactive.
Well, we like to be interactive, but some people don't like to be interactive.
Well, if they would be interactive, it'd make the show a little bit easier because then we don't have to talk all the time.
Well, you know, our job is to talk on all the time on radio.
Are we getting paid for this now?
No, we're not getting paid for it, but it's still something we're supposed to do. Anyway, so we're going back to Slaughterhouse this weekend. Why do you have to make things so difficult? And we're going to hopefully do the live YouTube from Slaughterhouse. If we cannot go live, we will record and download later. But the plan is to go live. It's not going to be until like 10:30 Arizona time. So that's really late for Eastern.
So all you people in New York, we know you're going to be awake.
So that's like 1:30 a.m. Eastern time.
Yeah, so as you're leaving the bar.
Oh, that's true, huh?
Turn it on.
Yeah, so if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube, we encourage you to do that right now. Well, after the show, not right now. But go to our YouTube channel. It's under Tucson Ghost Company. Hit subscribe. Hit that lovely little bell that will ring and ding to let you know when we're got new videos and when we're live and all that lovely stuff. Because we are going to try that this Saturday night, but it's not going to be until about 10:30 p.m. Arizona time. And then we still have training that we're doing with new members. So we have training, like 3 more training sessions. So that's been keeping us busy. And we are going out to another jail September 1st. Going to check out.
They finally found that, huh?
What, the jail?
Yeah, what you did. They finally found out what you did.
I didn't do anything. It's all you. I'm the sweet and innocent one.
They invited you and you were willing to accept the offer.
Well, so. I'm excited to be going out to the jail and investigating. And then we're going back to Fox Theater the very next day. So we have 2 investigations in a row. So September 1st and September 2nd. We are going to be tired that weekend.
You're driving?
Well, no, I'm not driving. You're driving.
Damn.
If you want to take a nap in the car during
Yeah, I can do that. Put cruise control on, take a little nap.
No, while we're investigating, take a nap. Not while you're driving.
Just said While driving?
No! I meant during the investigation, while we're investigating the jail, if you want to go take a nap so you're refreshed to drive back.
Oh.
That's what I meant. Oh, my goodness. Not while you're driving.
I'd be really refreshed if I just set the cruise control and took a nap.
No! It doesn't work that way. It really doesn't.
Well, according to one of your favorite movies, it does.
One of my favorite movies.
Back to the Future.
Flying
cars, guided. They self-freaking take you to where you need to go.
Yeah. This isn't real. That doesn't work.
That's what they predicted, 2015.
Okay. But let's move on. So September 1st and September 2nd, we have investigations. Then September 8th, we get to go check out one of the first original hotels in a town called Benson. So it was like one of the very first hotels ever built. And we're going to go check that out. That's going to be interesting. They actually have had cops have experiences in these hotels or in this hotel. Yeah. And that should be interesting. And then we have, you and I are going out of town.
Yeah.
And we're going to take a break. Kinda. I say kinda because it's your birthday weekend.
Yeah.
Which you get to take off your birthday, though.
Yeah, I'm going to end up sleeping most of it.
Well, September 13th, we will be cutting the show off a little bit early because we are going out to Tucson, and this is not a public event, so the public cannot go. But I don't know if it's going to air live or be recorded. I'm not sure which it's going to be, but we're going to be working directly with iHeartRadio. And we're going to be investigating Old Tucson until like 3 a.m. So you'll be in Old Tucson when the clock strikes midnight for your birthday. So we'll tell the ghost to tell you happy birthday. That's what we'll do. We'll tell the ghost, jump out, say surprise and happy birthday to Will. Maybe that'll work. You never know.
I prefer they just give me a bunch of money.
I don't think ghosts have money.
How do you know there's no ghost currency?
Well, if there was, I don't think we would be able to use it.
Well, there's a surefire way to find out.
Well, we can ask them, you know, to see if they'll give you a present or not. Although you may not like their presents, but, you know.
Well, as long as it's not ghost poop.
Alrighty then. But that is going to be on iHeartRadio. We'll get hopefully more information on how that's going to go. But that should be fun. And then that weekend, since that's your birthday, we are going out of town.
Yeah.
We're staying in Arizona, but we're going out of town. And we're going to stay in a haunted room. So that's our break. From all this investigating is going and staying in a haunted room. Go figure.
Sounds more like something you'd want to do on your birthday.
Well, we were going to do this before and we couldn't and we postponed it. And I asked you when you wanted to do it and you said for your birthday weekend. So, you know, it was your choice. So now you get to go and spend a night in a haunted room. Right.
You want to do that all the time?
Not all the time. I wish. I wish. September 29th is National Ghost Hunting Day. Now, we talked about this before on the show. We're doing it at Arcadia Ranch. But the new thing for everyone to know is we are opening it up to the public now.
So you can buy tickets to come join us.
On National Ghost Hunting Day.
Yep.
Yay! But here's the deal. There's two separate things going on. The VIP tickets, they're limited to only four. And those, you're going to be in the building with us as we're broadcasting live. So you'll actually get to see us broadcast and do the whole thing. Now, we limited it because the building is kind of small. And we're going to have all of our equipment set up. And if we brought in a lot of people, it would have been a lot of contamination and a lot of worrying about our cameras and everything.
Instead of actually doing what we were supposed to be doing.
So we limited it. But after the broadcast, we're opening it up and allowing more people in and doing a ghost hunt until midnight. So it's going to go from like 9:30 to midnight. We're going to allow more of the public in. So there's two types of tickets. People can buy the tickets at TucsonGhostTour.com. So
go buy them.
Yeah, go buy them. And part of the proceeds, actually 60% of them, go to Arcadia Ranch to preserve, you know, and restore and keep the property in working order. Now, September 29th isn't the only day we're going to be working with Arcadia. We're actually going back on October 20th, too.
Yes.
So we have two events at Arcadia to where people can buy tickets. And again, that's at TucsonGhostTour.com. And then October 13th, we have a brand new event where we're driving people to Gleason, Arizona. Now, we investigated Gleason, what was it, last weekend? Two weekends. Okay. I can't even remember what we did. What we had an investigation last weekend. Where did we investigate?
Arcadia.
Okay. Thank you. See, I can't even keep them straight. Okay. So we investigated Gleason a couple weekends ago. We did get some good EVPs, some pretty clear EVPs. Not a whole lot, but there's like one or two that were really clear. And it's a very interesting place, small jail. I keep wanting to say a hanging tree, but it's a jail tree.
Yes.
An old school, old hospital. We're going to show you all of this. What we're going to do is we are actually going to drive you to Gleason, which is a 1.5-hour drive from Tucson. We're going to give you onboard entertainment. We're going to, you know, play movies for you. We'll provide water. You're going to get to Gleason. You're going to hear about some of the history through a native. And then we're going to arm you with ghost hunting equipment and let you ghost hunt and then have you back to your car by midnight. So that's a brand new thing that we've never done before. And that's going to happen October 13th. And then we're working with Fox Theater again. They have an event on October 30th that we're working with Fox. October 27th, so a couple days beforehand, we're working with Borderlands Brewery for Spirits with Spirits. Now, the Gleason and Arcadia and Borderlands, you can buy on our website.
Yes.
At TucsonGhostTour.com. For the Fox Theater, you have to go to Fox Theater's address, which is Fox Tucson. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, we're most likely going to be at Comic-Con again this year. I don't see why we wouldn't be. I think for the most part, we, you know.
Aren't we already signed up for?
We're signed up, but we haven't gotten the final, yes, you're going to be involved. We've been doing it for the past, what, last three years. So I don't really see us not doing it, but you never know. Maybe they decide that they don't like us this year.
Well, that's a shame because we always fill the room.
Yeah, I know we do, but, you know, you never know. Mm. So once we get information for sure about Comic-Con, we'll let everyone know about that one. But a lot going on. If you are not on our Facebook page, please check us out. We got Tucson Ghost Society, Tucson Ghost Company, and of course, Mysteries Explained Facebook pages. And you'll see everything up to date all the time on what we're doing and events. And then on Twitter, we're at Mysteries Radio. We try to keep that up to date as much as possible, too. So please, and don't forget about the YouTube. And we'll, you know, remind you all about this, you know, after the show, too. So tonight, we have Gavestown Tours, and it's Gina and
Alicia.
Oh, okay, thank you. And I am going to try to see if I can add them right now.
We all know how you like Skype so much.
I know. I just have so many issues getting this done, and I don't know why. Because Skype doesn't like me.
No, they don't.
No, I think they think that I talk too much bad about them.
Yeah.
Hello?
Hello.
Hi, welcome to Mysteries Explained. How are you doing tonight?
So far, so good.
All right. Well, we are live on the radio right now. You're here with Becky and Will.
Hello.
Hey.
And for everyone listening, we would love for you to introduce yourselves to them.
Okay, well, I'm Jenna. Galveston Lantern Tours is our company, and I'm with my business partner and partner in crime, Alicia.
Well, hello. I love how you refer to her as partner in crime.
Well, over 20 years we've known each other. So, partner in crime it is.
So, have you been in business that long or no?
No, our company is fairly new. We were working for another company, and we were not really satisfied with what we were doing in our role. So we decided instead to branch out and cover a more broader topic than what we were doing. So it's been interesting. We've been falling in love with Galveston all over again.
Oh, yes.
Okay. And so how long have you been doing it then?
How long have we been doing this, Lisa?
Since May.
Oh, wow. So you are pretty much really brand new then.
The company is. As for giving tours, we've been doing that for over 3 years now. And paranormal things, well, that's been pretty much a lifelong for both of us.
Oh, wow. Very cool. So do you have, like, a paranormal team that you guys work with, too? Or is it just the tours?
We're very, very lucky in that down here in Galveston, pretty much all the local businesses believe in ghosts. Mm-hmm. And so everybody has a collaborative effort to share their findings and put together, you know, different types of investigations. There's even one specific store down here where the gentleman that runs the business with his wife, they actually make ghost hunting equipment. So we have a pretty well tight-knit community down here of ghost hunters.
Oh, very cool.
Yeah.
I wish we had that here.
Good luck with that.
Yeah, good luck with that.
Well, Galveston has such a wide variety of experiences. So many different types of historical events have happened, and I'm sure that Alicia would love to tell us about a little bit of that.
Well, we would love to hear it.
Well, when it comes to the history, with me, you've kind of got to narrow it down where to start, because I have been studying this island since I was 17 years old, learning the history a bit at a time over the years. And my library on Galveston books is probably 4 or 5 shelves deep. And since Rosenberg Library here on the island has such an amazing history center, I've been able to really dig into even farther. I mean, right now on my computer, I'm looking at Sanborn insurance maps to see what the floor plan essentially for the entire island, all the maps were looking like, where businesses were in 1885, to help learn about some of the buildings that we talk about. That, yeah.
And we had a lot of different types of catastrophes here in Galveston as well that really tend to lend themselves towards, you know, having ghosts, such as mysterious fires. Mm-hmm. We've had, of course, hurricanes. We've had things like the Black Plague was here for a while.
In 1920, actually, we had an epidemic of the Black Plague. Bubonic plague came in.
Yeah,
in June of 1920.
So we've had, you know, plus yellow fever, things like that. Civil War. There's a ton of things that contribute to the factors of ghosts down here.
There.
Yes.
Okay, for some reason my computer just, like, went into sleep mode and shut off, and I wasn't sure if I lost you all.
No, not at all. We're here.
Okay.
That kind of activity doesn't really surprise us. I was actually worried something like that would happen to us here, because we've set up shop for tonight at the Galvez.
Okay. I'm guessing that's a very haunted place?
Yes.
Very haunted. It was built in 1910.
Yeah, construction was completed in 1911.
And we actually are partnering with a lady that works here, and in October we're going to be putting together a package for people that want to stay overnight and do a paranormal investigation.
Oh, very awesome.
So what better way to place, you know, an interview like this than in a place like this? However, you know, when you are in a haunted place like this, a lot of times electronics don't always want to work.
No. So.
Right. We've had that, well, we'll not necessarily, but I've had that issue a lot. Whenever I've been followed home or anything like that, they tend to mess with the equipment and electronics more than anything.
Absolutely.
Yes. But I do need to put out a warning just in case. We are under a thunderstorm warning.
Okay.
We're actually under a flood warning, to be honest with you. The flood's not going to affect the show, but if we lose electricity, of course, that will.
Well, I feel
that wouldn't be a good thing.
I feel for you, and I hope it doesn't flood there, because we just went through Harvey last year, so we understand.
Yeah. Well, Arizona's a funny thing because, you know, you get a couple of drops of rain and we're flooded.
That's true. I actually visited Tombstone, and it's a little bit, I watched a lightning show come in with the rain bands, and it was amazing when I was there.
Yes. Yeah, we, the monsoons out here are crazy, and because of the fact that no one really thought about building things where, you know, it wouldn't flood.
Well, here the water kind of hits the dirt and starts running instead of soaking in. So if we get 3 inches of rain, you got water running down the street and all across the dirt and everything, because it doesn't actually soak in. It just wants to go where it wants to go.
Yeah.
And some of our roads would go through like river beds because there's not actually water in them. And it gets crazy when we get that kind of weather, but
we're very blessed in that Alicia is a phenomenal tour guide, but it never rains on her tour.
It never rains on me.
Oh, really?
Really?
So anytime there's rain in, the forecast, you get the tour?
Absolutely.
Pretty much. I mean, we have watched it. It is pouring. I am waiting inside somewhere before we're supposed to start checking people in for the tour. I step right out that door. It stops. And it doesn't pick back up.
Until after
I have said goodnight and have a wonderful evening. Be safe. And then it starts pouring again.
I guess you're on the good side of the rain gods or something then, huh?
I certainly hope so. I mean, they've named a hurricane after me, so.
Well, I guess that says something.
She's the eye of the storm.
Apparently so.
Yes.
Most of the time, that's true.
How funny is that? So where do your tours actually start then?
Well, we have one tour that starts on the seawall, and there's kind of this pagoda archway where the historic Balinese room used to be, and it's got benches and everything, and it's a very good place to start because it was the Balinese room. The owners of the potential property have put a list of all of the history, all of the things that have happened there, so that the guests for the seawall stories, they can actually read the stuff while they're waiting for everyone to get checked in and everything. And our haunted history tour down on the Strand starts at the Peanut Butter Warehouse, which is actually a building that I was researching right before you gave us a call.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, the haunted history tour that we do, it kind of winds itself off the beaten path, so we don't just stay on the Strand, because everybody always investigates the Strand, and it's a fantastic street, and there's a lot of stuff that's happening there, but if you get stuck on the Strand, you don't get to see or envision or imagine or even encounter any of the great things that are anywhere else. Mm-hmm. And we have Market Street, which is fantastic. We've got Post Office Street, Church Street, and Winnie, just all of these great places with all of this wonderful history. And a lot of it tends to get overshadowed by the fact that everybody only knows about the Strand.
Nice.
Yeah.
I mean, Sam Houston himself had given his final public address happened here in Galveston, and it happened on Church Street at the Tremont Hotel, where the Tremont Hotel was at the time. That's not something you find on the Strand. Or Mary Star of the Sea at the church, St. Mary's Basilica. To hear about this woman that was this statue of St. Mary that was considered the Statue of Liberty of the South for the time, you have to go looking for it now because the buildings are so much taller than they were in the 1890s and 1870s when she was the Statue of Liberty of the South.
Oh,
nice. Wow.
Mm-hmm. I'm a little bit of a history nerd.
Just a lot. It's all right.
No, you know, and in all honesty, you kind of have to be when it comes to the paranormal because it all ties in.
Yes.
Well, and the other part of it, too, is, like I said, we have a pretty tight-knit community of, you know, local business. And we have some fantastic shops and a lot of great restaurants. And people will completely miss them because they're not located on the Strand. We have Old Moon Deli and Pies, for instance. We have Proletariat, which is a fantastic bar, but is also home to the Artist Lofts. So you have a lot of interesting, eclectic groups of people that have just a tremendous amount of talent and just the things that they create and that are out on display. And you'd miss that completely if you never left the Strand.
Right. We are actually looking up
Galveston right now, and apparently there is a lot to do in Galveston.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. There is absolutely a lot to do in Galveston.
And looking at some of the stuff that there is to do, I'm thinking my wife is probably going to be wanting me to take her there.
You should. Yes. You should bring her down here. Bring her down here and we'll take you on some investigations. It'd be great.
Oh, that'd be awesome. But yeah, there's a...
Well, why don't we let
them... Yeah, there's a lot. Why don't you tell us all there is to do there? Because I'm looking at it going, wow, you can spend some time there.
Well, we have Haunted Mayfield Manor, which is a fantastic ghost haunted house situation, and it's a truly haunted building. Alicia, tell them a little bit about that.
Well, Mayfield Manor, I mean, it's one of those haunted houses that you go to usually in October, but they run all year long. And it's very small, but it's based in the history of the 1900 storm. And it's very, very well done for such a very small kind of attraction. They also have in the building the Jean Lafitte Pirate Museum, Pirates of the Gulf Coast. But the building that they're in, the Buttero building, was a cannery for a long time. And it's incredibly haunted. They have a spirit there. I can't remember his name.
Tom?
I think it's Tom. And he likes to take selfies in their photo booth. He likes to mess with the equipment. He likes to rearrange the artifacts in the Pirate Museum.
Well, you got me on Pirate Museum alone. I'm sorry.
Right? You don't normally hear about that, but we have one here, and it's incredible. We also have a railroad museum.
Yes.
That is also incredibly haunted. We had a situation, what was it, 2 weeks ago with you and your mom, Alicia?
My mom is an unwilling medium. You know, she can't help it. But okay. we were my uncle had come to town and he wanted to go to our railroad museum. And so we were going and my mom and I got separated and she asked me to pull out my ghost radar app. You know, that wonderful random word generator that the spirits really, really like to play with, or at least in my experience, they play with mine a lot and they have a lot to say. And my mom and I are playing with it and we're trying to walk into this one particular rail car. It says, heavy door, push hard. We push hard. This door isn't budging. My sister comes up. We push hard. This door isn't budging to go into this rail car. Little bitty old lady walks up and she opens the door easy and walks in. My sister follows her and stands on the other side. And my mom and I kind of test this theory, you know, maybe it just was jammed or something. She shuts the door. My mom tries to push the door open. It won't budge. I push the door. It won't budge. And we get this overwhelming feeling of giggliness. Like somebody is on the other side of that door, holding it shut, laughing at us, just being mischievous and playful. And we finally say, please just let us in. We would really like to tour the car. And the door opens easy.
Wow.
It was such a fun feeling. Mm-hmm.
And then for another example, here at the Galvez, if you're sitting across the street on one of our beautiful benches looking out at the water and you happen to turn around and look at the Hotel Galvez, it's not uncommon for one of the turret lights to go off by itself and then come back on repeatedly. And the people that work here, the maintenance guys, will tell you they don't go up there unless they absolutely have to. So, you know, something's messing with it.
They've had an electrician look at it to make for sure that the light was fine, and the light, the fixture, the everything is supposed to be in working order, and the light still just won't stay on all the time.
But see, but we don't just have fun things like that down here. We also have Soundbar.
Yes.
Which is a fantastic karaoke bar that Alicia frequents a lot.
I'm the karaoke diva, yes.
She is, that's true. But it's okay because they love her down there. And like I said, we try to build those local relationships, and we're actually going to be doing a vampire pageant there in October. And all of the proceeds from it are going to be benefiting a local domestic violence abuse shelter. So
that's very cool.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a little out of the box, but we like it.
Wow.
Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're still looking up everything there. You already got me at Pirate Museum. That was like my major thing. Here's, you know, and you got me at Haunted too, so you already have me, okay? But it also looks like there's some type of amusement park.
There's, actually, we can see it from here. It's the Pleasure Pier.
Yep.
Yes.
Yep. Yeah. Pleasure Pier, because that has a whole nother history to it.
It costs, after tax, about $30 a person to go and have an all-day ride pass. You can ride the Iron Shark roller coaster. My favorite ride is the Texas Flyer, which is a big swing that goes around and around, and it takes you very, very high up. You can see the whole island. I like that view, and it's a lot of fun. The history of the pier, if you would, I could give you the history of the pier. It's actually
I would love it because I love amusement parks.
Well, we had initially decided to build an amusement facility there in the 1940s. Unfortunately, World War II came up, and it was delayed a little bit until the builders could find a kind of steel that wasn't being used in the war effort. So we built the pier. We're about to get ready for the grand opening in 1943, and we get struck by a surprise hurricane, which, of course, stopped it for a little while. We called it a surprise hurricane because this is 1943. We're in the middle of World War II. Galveston at the time was a pretty important military base. We had the Marines, we had the Coast Guard, we had the Air Force, all stationed right here. People had seen German U-boats out in Galveston Bay and out in the Gulf of Mexico. And so when the newscasters saw that we had saw that we had a hurricane coming, it was a matter of national security not to tell anybody. So we didn't. And so the island is struck by this Category 3 hurricane, and nobody knew it was coming. There was no preparation for it. And when the news came out about it, they said, oh, yeah, we were just struck by a tornado. It's okay. Nothing bad happened. We're great. And for years and years and years, that was a secret hurricane. And so we refer to it as a surprise hurricane. We rebuilt, of course. We fixed the damage and opened up in the 1940s. In 1951, they added a roller coaster and all the different rides that became kind of the idea of the Pleasure Pier, like in the Eastern Board, where all of the
Coney Island.
Yes, I had gone blank there for a second. In 1962, Hurricane Carla hit, damaged the pier, and instead they built a hotel over the amusement pier, built the flagship hotel, which stood until Hurricane Ike. After Hurricane Ike, Tillman Fertitta, who owns the Landry's Corporation, bought the pier. He actually worked at the flagship hotel as a lifeguard when he was in high school. So he came back home, bought the property that was the hotel that used to be the Pleasure Pier, and rebuilt the Pleasure Pier where it originally was.
Very cool.
Nice.
Oh, yes. And there's a lot. You'll find down here in Texas, especially here in Galveston, that we're very community-based. So if there's something that can be done for the community, pretty much all of the local businesses will do whatever they can. We have, and if you weren't, you know, sold at Pirates and Haunted Things, we also have the author of Angel Talk is here also, Kathy Ketching. She wrote Angel Talk, and she has a couple of other books that came out after that one. And her husband, Mike, they actually run a store called Mysticats. And that is on the Strand, but it's a really interesting store. They sell all kinds of things. When you walk in, it just makes your heart happy to be in there. So definitely a cool place to check out. And then there's the Haunted Bar where we start our Haunted History Tour.
Three doors down.
And that was actually a brothel at one point. So
we're nailing down the timeline on that one.
But we have all kinds of interesting things that, you know, that happen in a lot of fun places to check out. So you definitely do want to come down here.
You have a palace.
You do.
I'm like, you have a palace.
Yeah, it was when it was built, it was called Gresham Castle. It was built for Senator Walter Gresham and his family. After he had passed away, his family decided, because they were Catholic, they decided to sell it to the Galveston-Houston Archdiocese, who turned it into Bishop Burns' private residence. And so it became known as Bishop's Palace after it was called Gresham Castle.
Very interesting information.
It's not useless. It's coming in handy right now.
Yes, it is.
It is, because I'm like asking you all these questions. And you have the Moody Mansion?
Oh, yes. The Moody family is a very prominent family down here in Galveston. And we absolutely are in love with their house. It is a tremendous asset to the community. They also have, it's the Children's
Museum is in the basement of the Moody Mansion.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
And it's a really, really fun place.
And the Moodys also have brought us the Moody Gardens.
Yes.
And we could not live without the Moody Gardens.
I couldn't, at least, with my kids.
Oh, and that, wow. The Moody Gardens, that's in one of the glass pyramids?
Yes.
Three glass pyramids, yeah.
Wow.
With a rainforest pyramid, a discovery pyramid, which has, there's different things that come through the discovery pyramid. Like the Da Vinci exhibit was here earlier this year. Right now there's a big interactive music exhibit. My son loves that one. He gets to play with all the different instruments and everything. And the aquarium, which has just completed being restored, renovated, just redone. It is my 7-year-old son's favorite place on the island right now.
And
he's a little shark mad.
And they also do the fantastic Festival of Lights every year. And that is just incredible to see. I mean, just so many Christmas lights in one place.
Mm-hmm.
And they're in these different elaborate, intricate designs. They do a fantastic job putting it together, and we go every year.
And Iceland.
Yes, and Iceland. We can't forget Iceland.
Iceland is an exhibit entirely made up of ice sculptures. It's immersive. It's 6 degrees, which is a bit too cold for me.
Yeah, that's cold.
Mm-hmm. But the art, the artistry of it is amazing.
And if you don't want to go into a place that's freezing, we also have, after Hurricane Ike came through, a bunch of trees died. And so they have artists that turned the carcass of the trees into fantastic pieces of artwork on the East End.
Wow. You also have a paddle boat or a paddle wheel boat.
Yes, the Colonel paddle boat.
That looks beautiful.
Off its bayou for about an hour and comes back. You can buy drinks and snacks and just sit and enjoy the view.
Or now, are any of these haunted?
Everything in Galveston is haunted.
If you really want a haunted experience on a ship, we have the Alyssa.
Yeah.
And the Alyssa
tall, is the tall ship of Texas.
The tall ship of Texas. And she is gorgeous to see. There was actually a lot of talk about EVP readings and stuff like that that people have gotten whenever they've gone into the different places on the ship itself.
Yeah.
So it's definitely a must check out.
Yeah.
And then if that's not enough for you, you could always do a Sunset Harbor tour and look for the ghost ships in the harbor itself.
We so have to go. But it's like 16 hours away. Can we drive that?
So let's see. Where's Rich?
What haunted hotel would we have to stay at?
The Galvez.
She says the Galvez. I say the Tremont. Either way, it's a Wyndham property. You can't go wrong. See, you have pros and cons. See, at the Galvez, you're right next to the seawall, so you have that beautiful view, and they've got a ton of ghosts, and it's a very elegant hotel, and it's, you know, it's an antique, basically. It's wonderful and just so grand and beautiful. But if you go to the Tremont was actually put together who was it?
The Mitchell Foundation.
Yeah, the Mitchell Foundation. And it's two different buildings that were collaborated into one. And they have a rooftop bar there. It's right there by the Strand and all the action that's happening downtown. And it's also very haunted.
That is one of my favorite views at night is from the rooftop bar. You can see all the way across the island, both sides.
And the other really amazing thing about it is walking into their lobby is also like taking a step back into time. They have done a fantastic job of maintaining the property. They have that lovely bar in the lobby.
Yes, the Tijoux Bar, which was the Tremont Opera House bar.
Oh, that's right. We also have the Grand.
1880 something.
We also have the Grand, which is our opera house, which is the Opera House of Texas.
Yes.
So, you know, you'd have to check that out too.
We are certified tourism ambassadors, so it is part of who we are to know as much about our island as possible. And if we don't know it, we research it.
And, you know, it's our job to tell people, come down to the island, because you'll really love it down here.
Right. Well, you know, you have me because you have amusement park, you have pirates, you have haunted, and you have water.
And she probably just threw it all on the bucket list.
I'm like, well, you know, in Arizona, in order to see water, well, when it doesn't flood, that is, you know, we have to basically, you know, go to California. So
you have to travel to water.
Mm-hmm. I'm like, yeah, you got me one over here.
So how far are you from San Padre Island?
Depending upon the direction you go, about 6-7 hours.
Okay.
Why was that asked?
Oh, because my buddy lives there.
Oh.
Because he has a bucket list too, but it's not here.
Well, he keeps trying to get me to go out to San Padre to visit him.
And, it is beautiful down there. Like the entire Texas coast, you really can't go wrong. It's just that we happen to love Galveston. We
have our favorites.
We have our favorites, and you know, and this is it. You know, it's really nice that, you know, on an island where we get, you know, thousands of tourists, you know, all throughout the year, you can still walk in to any place and see the local residents, and they all know each other. So even though it's got, you know, 1,000 strangers coming in at all times, all the people that are really here all the time know each other. And right. That's really an amazing thing.
So come
thing.
Down and go bar hopping with me.
Yes.
That sounds like a plan.
Absolutely.
Now, you know, there would be one thing left that would completely send me over edge, though.
What's that?
Do you have anything Disney related there?
We have Disney Cruise Lines the Disney cruises are here in from November to February.
All right, babe.
So you can take a Disney cruise out of Galveston.
That just sent me over. We're good. It's got all my favorite things in one place. How can you go wrong?
I guess you can.
You really can't. You know, we have so much history. You would get lost in the library for days. I mean, truly get lost in the library for days. And then you'd walk out and go down to a bookstore and see all of the amazing books that the locals have written about this area. And then you would be lost in those books for even more days. And then you'd go around and you'd, you know, check things out. I love to go around to the buildings after hours and take pictures through the windows. And a lot of times you get spiritual activity. And that's, you know, just saying, hey, you know, I'm going to take some photos. And if anybody wants to pop up, let's see what we get. And we get some pretty fantastic things at different times.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and then our streets are very well lit, even late at night. You can be walking down Post Office, and it can be 3:30 in the morning, and it's just as bright as it was at 6:30 in the afternoon. So it's very cool. The crime rate's not too bad. And, you know, pretty much since everybody knows everyone here, you know, it's a pretty good community. It's very safe.
We're very self-policing.
Very, very much.
You don't belong, get out.
Make sure you stick with the locals for that part, right?
Well, you know, and we have a rich history, and it encompasses so many things. And we love the fact that we have a lot of people that come here. We get to meet new people. Every tour, there's somebody from somewhere far away, and they get to take back a little bit of our island with them and tell more people. And that's a great feeling to know that we've been able to, you know, send our island away somewhere far so that people can share the word that we're here. And, you know, we love to meet new people, and we love to have them come down here.
And come back.
And come back, yes. We actually have some fantastic firefighters that are out in Kansas, and they come back every summer and take our tours, and they keep up with everything we're doing on Facebook, and we love them. Because, you know, it's nice to be able to make friends that are far away and see other places and, you know what's going on in other areas of the United States. It's cool.
Right, yeah. Well, like I said, you've completely...
Deep soldier.
Yeah. There's no question about it. We just have to do it during a time that Disney Cruise goes out of there is all.
Well,
that way I can get everything I love in one go.
Yes, and it won't be quite as hot then either.
Yes, and the mosquitoes will be dead for a little while.
Yeah, I don't like mosquitoes. I can avoid mosquitoes because they love me. I don't like them.
Mm-hmm.
Love-hate relationship?
Yeah. Very much so. But, yeah, I'm, like, thrilled now, and we have to plan a vacation because of the fact that they have Pirates amusement park, Disney, haunted places, water. Do I need to go on with the list?
No, I pretty much already know the list.
And he's mentally going over his bank statement to see.
He's going, yeah, I'm taking away her bank card now.
Yeah, because, you know, when you come down, because eventually you'll make it here, you'll also have to stop into the witchery. Because you'll have to go and get your tarot cards read, and you'll have to meet the owners and see the beautiful establishment that they have as well. We have a lot of really good friends and a lot of businesses that we really love down here, and we're always happy to have anybody come down and, you know, share in those places with us, because it's really incredible.
Yeah, it sounds like a really cool spot, and I'm definitely wanting to check it out. I don't know when, but it's definitely going on our bucket list, or at least mine.
Well, if it's on yours, I'll be there too.
So. Trying to get stuck with my bucket list, don't you?
Yeah, I do. Unfortunately.
Well, you know, but the Disney Cruise only runs out of there, you said, during like the winter months?
Yeah.
Mm. So that won't work for renewal honeymoon thing. That makes a lot of sense, doesn't it?
No, it doesn't.
Okay, well, I don't want to say honeymoon because it's a renewal of vows, but we are hopefully going on some type of vacation after we renew our vows.
How many years?
It'll be 10 years when we renew our vows in May.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Husband and I will be 10 years in July.
Very cool.
Anytime we go out of town, he's last time we went to Austin, he told me I wasn't allowed to do anything history. So yeah, we know how this goes.
Well, he doesn't really get away with that. I think, well, the last vacation we didn't do anything paranormal. We actually got away from not doing anything because the last vacation we had our kids.
Yep.
And we went to San Diego, then San Francisco, and then Hollywood. And we didn't do anything paranormal at any of those. Which was probably the first time in 5 years that has happened.
Wow.
Because usually when we go on vacations, we do something paranormal.
Mm-hmm. Of course you do.
Well, that's not true.
Because it's part of who you are.
When we do family vacations, we usually don't do anything paranormal.
Well, when we go to Disneyland, we don't do paranormal. Because I'm too busy being in awe over Disneyland.
Yes.
So I live it up at Disneyland. But like we went all the way back to Toledo, Ohio. And when we were in Toledo, because that's where I'm from, we did something paranormal there. And that was, you know, flying back. And we still ended up, we did two things paranormal while in Toledo. And then when him and I did a trip to San Diego, we did the Whaley House. So we tend to. The only times that we haven't is when we've done Disneyland, basically. But other than that, we have. Excuse us. My husband forgot to silence his phone. Your phone just went off.
It's okay. A little queen never hurt anybody. Okay.
Right.
Yeah, far worse ringtones.
Unless you happen to live with the queen, and then you're in trouble.
See, in October, we have a lot of really cool things that are going to happen.
Yes.
And so we are obviously going to encourage anybody to come down, especially during that month. I mean, next month in September, we have the anniversary of the 1900 storm, and we're doing three different special events for mm-hmm. that particular situation. We're going to basically, you know, talk about the different aspects of the storm itself, and you know, we're going to do it from different perspectives and cover different topics regarding that particular event.
We've got, you know, one of our events actually doesn't cover the paranormal because some people really just want to hear the history.
Right.
But our haunted 1900 storm tour is selling out hand over fist really quickly. But we're trying to offer something for everybody for that.
Yeah. So, and one of the really cool things is that we're also putting together a brunch during the day on that Saturday, which is September 8th. We're putting together a brunch so that people can actually eat lunch in what was at one time part of the Weather Service.
It was the National Weather Service for Texas and Louisiana during the 1900 storm, and I believe until the 1920s mm-hmm. when they moved it.
Yeah. So we have that going on, and then in October, we are still trying to finalize a few things, but we do have the vampire pageant that's going to happen, mm-hmm. and we have the investigation here at the Gavest going to happen
Friday, October 26th.
And then we also have a ghost hunt and party happening at the Levy Building, and that's going to be fantastic.
October 13th.
Wow. Yes. Now, we have a friend in the chat room. Okay. Her name's Raina, and she's listening. She's part of our paranormal team out here. But she makes the comment that you guys have antique shops, too.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah. Yes, we do.
I get grounded from the antique shops.
You know, you ladies are bearing me more and more in having to go to Galveston.
Well, I don't know about you, but I'm a very big fan of vintage Halloween stuff. Like 1930s and 40s Halloween decorations. And there is this one shop down
St. John.
Oh, man. They have some serious, serious business happening there. And I'm just like, oh, all of my money.
Yeah, we're dangerous in antique. Well, I'm dangerous in antique shops.
when my kids grow up and move out, I am redoing my house, restoring it to early 1900s, antiques and all. And my husband is not looking forward to that bill. No.
Sounds familiar, babe?
Lifelong familiar.
Yeah, I love those old-fashioned, you know, Victorian-style sofas and things like that. And we've seen them. I mean, they're expensive, but we won't even try to buy them because of the fact that we have four kids and four dogs. So not happening right now.
Not yet. Teenage daughter and a second grader son? No. Things will get broken.
Yep. We know that far too well.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I pretty much quit buying her nice things that I think she would like because every time I buy her something, the kids break it.
But if I buy it, it doesn't get broke. How's that? I don't know how that works. But
are scarier works. Than dads.
That's true. That's really true. I didn't think about that.
Moms are much scarier than dads.
He's thinking about that.
You know, I have a comment for that, but I'm just going to leave it alone.
Why? Because you're on the show with three women and you don't want
to? No, not at all. You know, I'm not afraid to say anything.
Yeah, I know. But I'm right next to you, so that's one of the issues.
Well, you know, another really cool thing that you can do when you come down is we also have dolphin tours.
Okay, you ladies really need to quit.
Are you serious?
I'm not lying. We absolutely do have dolphin tours, yes.
You probably don't know, but I have a tattoo of a dolphin. I love dolphins.
Mm-hmm.
They're one of my favorite.
I did not know, but I just really felt like I should tell you. We have this. It's something we do here.
Will's not appreciating any of this, but I'm loving it. Thank you.
You're welcome. And I will tell you, we've actually done quite a few of the dolphin tours. And they're out there and you can see them. They get very close to the boats.
Aww.
It's very cool. It's very, very cool.
The problem would be keeping her in the boat also.
Well, you know, if that's not enough for you, then we have to ask if you believe in ghosts.
Well, yeah.
You do? Do you believe in ghost crabs?
Ghost crabs. Well, I've never seen any, but that sounds interesting.
They exist, and they're down here on our beaches.
Oh, wow.
It's ghost crab hunting. We have these itty-bitty, like, about the biggest ones are, like, 2 inches wide. I thought they were called sand crabs because my dad has taken us ghost hunting anytime we go to the beach for my entire life. And there's these itty-bitty sand-colored crabs for camouflage. And you see, they come out at night, and you see this little bitty thing go across the ground, and you look a little bit closer. They're these itty-bitty crabs that just look transparent because their markings are to camouflage with the sand. And so they're actually called ghost crabs. They're scientific, well, not the Latin scientific name, but you can look up ghost crabs and find them mostly along the Atlantic.
Oh, we're being asked if they're tasty.
I don't think there's enough meat on them to taste.
They are very little, but very cute.
There's probably not enough meat for flavor.
Probably.
So they're just little appetizers.
Well, then you can say you ate a ghost.
That's true.
Oh, my God. So we have another question that came in, and they want to know if you have anything which, if I can talk.
Anything with attachments.
Thank you.
Do we have anything with attachments? Like,
if you've gone antique shopping and brought home anything or through tours or anything like that.
Have we ever had that happen? We've had certain situations where, you know, but most of the ghosts down here, they're not really, you know, malicious or anything. Just in my own personal experience in my house, I grew up in a haunted house. So I don't know what it's like to live somewhere where there's not a bunch of stuff going on that's not supposed to. But I haven't ever really had anything really attached too much that we've bought. I mean, you know, I'm pretty good though about when something new comes into the house, I sage it and put some crystals in it or around it and try to make sure that, you know, I don't have those types of energies come in, because, you know, I've grown up in a haunted house and I've seen some things. So, you know, I generally try to combat that kind of stuff.
And here on the, I haven't had anything, since I've lived here on the island, things will, if anything tries to follow me home, it doesn't get past that front door, because I have a couple of spirits in my house, and this is their house too. And they don't let anything else come in because that is their property.
Oh, wow.
They're
protective, huh?
They're very protective. They like music. They really love music in my house. I've been listening to Pandora and had the Pandora channel change on me to the big band channel, which doesn't bother me. I love the music too. It's just really fun when I've got my phone across the room, it changes channels and people are like, how did you change the channel from here? I didn't. The ghost changed the channel for us. We're listening to Glenn Miller now. But
so do you name that ghost Alexa?
No.
Oh my goodness, Will.
I know, I'm terrible.
Yes, you are, but that's beside the point. All right, so let's get back a little bit to your tours, because we got totally kind of off subject. How many different tours do you actually offer?
Three?
Okay, and what, do you have like different names for them all, or...?
We do, because Alicia names everything, and it's great.
Okay, and what are the names of them?
We have Haunted History, which is the one that we were talking about that starts on the Strand.
All right.
We have Seawall Stories, which is the one, of course, that starts here on the seawall that I mentioned earlier, that starts at where the Balinese room used to be. And then we have Wicked Wednesdays.
Ooh, and sounds interesting.
Yeah, Wicked Wednesdays is our discount night, pretty much. And it's the night that we give our Franken tours, where depending upon what the particular guide's mood is, that's where we go and that's what we talk about that night. And it makes it really, really easy for, you know, the seasonal things, topical things that are happening, like something's happening in the news. Well, this is actually very similar to this that has happened here, or, you know, talking about the Christmas time spirits or the spirits that are around different times of the year.
So that one's kind of like your changing tour then.
Yes. Yeah. It changes with tour guides. It changes with where you want to walk your group, because we give ourselves a 2-hour window in order to do our tour. And so that gives us the flexibility to walk around more than just the Strand. So we can go in pretty much any direction. And, you know, we can take our tour down different streets that they wouldn't normally go down. And we can talk about things that are, you know, unexpected, or things that they wouldn't have, you know, ever thought to ask about or to learn, because they wouldn't have experienced it otherwise. So it's pretty fun. And, you know, it's all inclusive of ghosts, because everything down here is haunted. So it works out. And we have a lot of really good stories and a lot of fun things that we like to share, but we don't all like the same stories. Right. So, you know, whereas I might really want to tell the story about Ritter's Cafe, Alicia might really want to tell the story about, you know, Henley Market or, you know, the Grand or something. And so we do it that way so that every experience is completely different and it's very organic. And that way we, you know, nothing's faked or, you know, or pre-planned. It's just, you know, you map your route the day that you want to do it, and you take the people on the tour, and they have a great time. They really love it.
Yeah, it sounds really interesting.
It does.
So how many tour guides do you have? Is it just the two of you, or do you have more?
Well, we actually, when we very first started, there were four of us. But the other two that were that started with us, they decided that they wanted to challenge their lives in other ways and kind of get away from some of the ghost stuff that was happening within their own lives. And so they stepped away. However, we have a sister tour guide that we've worked with in the past, and her name is Ellie, and we absolutely love her. She moved away last year.
We wanted her back.
She moved to Utah, and we were like, please don't go. And then every day since then, we've been like, please come back. And so we've convinced her to come back for October to help us out. So it's going to be great because we love her, and she's a fantastic guide, and we really couldn't think of anybody better for the job. I mean, you know, we couldn't have find anyone better than Ellie.
Oh, very cool.
You did warn her before she moved to Utah. There's nothing in Utah.
We tried. But she loves it out there. She thinks it's beautiful. She's had a lot of success with, you know, getting access into the community and, you know, making friends and all that kind of stuff. And so it's been a positive experience for her.
And being there with her sister, family comes first, always.
Yes.
Well, that's true. They do. But sometimes you have to uproot your family and get them to move.
That's true, too. So, Ellie, come home.
Yes.
Just bring the family with you.
Now, when Ellie lived here in Galveston, her apartment was extremely haunted, and it wasn't a good kind of haunting. So that was a situation where even if she was, you know, not going to leave, she still would have had to move to another apartment because it was really not good there.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. There was a mirror at the end of a hallway in her apartment, and it just was just not right. There was something in there. And once we moved all of her furniture out, it was very obvious that there was a presence there that people really shouldn't mess with.
Wow. Yeah, that's interesting. Mm-hmm.
Even if we could have got her to stay on the island, we would have had to have gotten her out of that house.
Right.
Absolutely.
Yeah, well, like I said, you've won me over. Apparently, you've run some people over in the chat room, too, saying that they really want to come visit. So,
well, they should. Send them our way. We'd love to have them.
As tourism ambassadors, that's kind of our job.
We have Big Blue. We can put the team in Big Blue and take turns driving and go down there.
Take turns driving? What, 16 hours?
It's 16 hours, according to Google.
It's... no big deal to drive.
All right. Well, if it's 16 hours according to Google, then you should probably add about 3 hours for traffic in Houston.
Yeah. Oh, that sounds fun.
Well, they're doing a lot of construction in the heart of the city, and so it really slows down the freeways a lot. But once you get past that, you're great.
Highway Interstate 45 holds the Guinness Book of World Records for the longest time in construction. Every time they fix, they finish something, they break another thing.
I think that's just Texas in general, because every time I've driven through there, the freeway is always being worked on.
Oh, yes. We're notorious for that. But down here on the island, the roads are pretty good, and so you don't have anything to worry about once you actually get here.
And ask us and we'll tell you the secret ways that we don't tell the tourists.
See, you get in on the secret.
Yeah, absolutely.
Don't drive on the street. Take a boat.
Well, that works too.
But see, we have a paranormal team of, what, 11 people?
Yeah.
I think it is. I've lost count.
Well, 12. We're up to 12.
We're up to 12 now? Okay. And our van holds, what, 15?
Yep.
So see? Paranormal trip.
Yeah, you have room for all your people and all of your handy, nifty investigative tools.
And your bathing suits.
I don't know if some of our team members would want to get into bathing suits, but I think we should plan.
Better start slush fund.
I know. You know, what we could do is have a little fun, start going to where if anyone on the team curses, wait, I would be the one putting in the most money.
I'm broke.
We can't do if anyone flips anyone off, because again, that would be me putting in all the money. We have to think of what all the other ones do.
Anytime anybody says yes to you or okay.
No, I don't want them to stop saying yes or okay.
That would be hysterical.
No.
I would laugh my ass off.
I gotta think of a way to start a fund here to where if anyone does something, they have to donate to the, you know, trip fund.
I'm liking the idea of anytime anybody says yes or okay to you, because then they'd be like, no. And then you'd be like, I need this done. And they'd be like, no, I can't.
That would be really difficult, since usually I'm the one that has to, you know, tell people what needs to be done.
Oh, and then they'd come to me and I'd go, oh, go ask Becky.
Well, we would hopefully get a lot of money very quickly that way then, because they would have to say okay.
Not really.
No, you're not helping. So not helping the situation at all. Yeah, see, even Raina's saying she'd go broke if she has to tell me, you know, she's putting money every time she tells me yes or okay. They would all go broke because, you know, I'm the one that has to give out duties and what they need to do.
Mm-hmm. They'd have to get really creative with their language. Pull out the thesauruses.
They would just have to learn to be defiant.
Or just not say yes or okay, but tell me that they will do it in a roundabout way. That would be even better.
Yes.
And they can't do it in a foreign language, because I'll know what they're saying.
Absolutely. How about that?
Okay, if you say so.
Yeah. See?
Well, yeah, that's obvious, but, you know. See, and Raina's putting out the reminder that I own their souls. It's in the contract, so they cannot deny saying yes or okay to me.
Well, then, see, there's a little bit of trouble on that whole front, then I would think, maybe. I just need to renegotiate those contracts a little bit.
Well, they weren't smart enough to read that part.
The fine print that says it, you know, we own them now.
All right, I see. Yeah, no, we encourage everybody to come out. We have a lot of great events that are coming up. We've got a website. Our website is
lanternlightgalveston.com.
Okay, and we did find you on Facebook.
Yep, we're on Facebook. We're on Twitter. We have an Instagram. We work all the social media outlets. Well, I primarily do that because I'm the communications major person here, so that's me. But yeah, we do all of the social media stuff, and then we put together events and activities, you know, paranormal investigations, things like that. And then, of course, we do our tours. We're kind of pretty well-rounded in that way. We enjoy all of it, and we love Galveston, so it works out for us.
All right. So I have to ask, and you know, I want to hear from each of you.
Okay.
Which location is your absolute favorite?
On the tour or off?
Either way.
Because my favorite location is the Hotel Galvez.
Okay.
It's both personal and paranormal. I mean, one of their spirits is the bride. Some people have called her the guard. There's another that might be a different one, but might not be the same spirit that the gardenia lady, where you can smell gardenias. My husband and I got married here almost 10 years ago. And before the wedding, when I was planning the wedding, I had decided that all of the men in the wedding party had to wear gardenias in their lapels for the gardenia lady, who may or may not be the same spirit, the same entity as the bride that's seen throughout the hotel. But we honored her by having them wear gardenias in their lapel. Now, the night of my wedding, it rained cats and dogs. It stormed. It was the worst storm of the summer. And as we're promenading from the music hall, which is one of the big ballrooms, to go up to our our honeymoon suite on the seventh floor, they're taking pictures and blowing bubbles and everything. And one of the big ghost stories of the Galvez, other than the bride, is the portrait of Bernardo de Galvez. Galveston was named after Bernardo de Galvez. He was the viceroy of Spain, of Texas, of all of that back then. One of the portrait of him stands right there in front of the entrance to the music hall. They say it's a haunted painting, and you have to ask permission before you take pictures. Otherwise, the pictures will turn out all wrong. Well, this is a wedding party. Pictures are being taken constantly all the time, regardless of anything else. Right. So there's a picture of me and my husband walking down the east veranda, heading to go up to the honeymoon suite. And right there between us and the portrait of Bernardo de Galvez is a face. You blow the picture up, you can see straight through it. We caught a full apparition in our wedding picture.
Wow.
It's actually part of the ghost tour of the Galvez now. But that's the paranormal reason why, is it's very, very personal to me spiritually and everything else. It's also a very, very beautiful place. I like to spend as much time here as I can manage. I actually live just a couple of blocks away, which is why I can sneak over here as often as I want. But combining the history, combining the spirits, combining my personal experiences here, this is my favorite place on the island.
Very cool.
Now, my favorite place on the island, I have several that I absolutely love. The Tremont is my favorite hotel. I absolutely love to sit there because it's very calming and it's very just elegant and beautiful. And so I love to sit there and do my work. But if it's for paranormal stuff, I love to sit on the beach across from the Galvez and just look for ghost ships out in the water and then be able to see the activity that's happening here at the Galvez from across the street. I just love this place also.
Wow. Well, it definitely sounds like you guys have a very interesting town, and I literally am sold on going there. I don't think Will appreciates that, but...
No, I like to travel. I'm good.
I know. He's looking at your website right now, by the way.
So you have a Storm Stories brunch that you're going to be doing once a month?
We're going to be having a spooky brunch once a month. Storm Stories is the theme of the first brunch that we're doing.
Okay.
We're looking at having probably the first Saturday of every month, having a spooky brunch over at Old Moon Deli, having special speakers come in and talk about, you know, paranormal, talk about, I would love to have someone from the Historic Foundation to come in one day, have an investigator come in and discuss, for example, like maybe for the October brunch, have an investigator come in and talk about the hows and the whys and have almost a seminar while we're having good food and great drinks.
Yep. Show us all the ghost hunting equipment and actually show us how they use it and things of that nature.
Yeah.
And then also we're not just covering that side of the brunch also, but also, you know, have somebody come in from funerary service and talk about, you know, the evolution of the things, all things funeral. So, you know, I mean, we have a lot of ideas for different things we want to do, and we have great friends at Old Moon Deli that are willing to let us, you know, have the space and actually create these events. So we're very blessed in that.
That is very cool.
What else are you questioning, babe?
No, I'm not questioning. Also have a, they're doing a 1900s Storm Stories Strand Area tour.
Mm-hmm.
For the anniversary of the storm?
Yes.
And when is that going to take place?
That is September 8th. That's going to be at 9 p.m. And then we also have Storm Stories Seaside, which is going to be at 6 p.m. Basically, we're taking you through the historical events of the Strand and the Seaside and the different stories that impacted both from different perspectives.
Mm-hmm. The Strand is going to cover more of the ghosts and the paranormal that came out of that disaster. I mentioned earlier that we had one event that was more haunted and one event that was more just history. And that's the event that I was talking about.
Okay.
More of the haunted in the evening and more of the just of the history in the early after in the early evening.
And we had a lot of people that came to us over the years of us being tour guides that said, you know, we're really interested in what's going on with the storm information, and we really want to know, but we just don't have the mobility to walk 2 hours to get the information. And so we figured we would put together a couple of events. That way, you know, we could have for the agile, active person that wants to walk the 2 hours and see the buildings and, you know, actually hear the stories out on the streets, we could put that together for them, but also have something so people that are a lot more limited, they could actually get down on the beach in their comfy beach chairs and beach blankets and just kind of relax and, you know, enjoy the story of what happened and, you know, and basically, you know, get that different perspective on it. And then the brunch, of course, we'll be talking more about the weathermen and about the events
the
that led
that
up.
We're in.
Yeah, leading up to the events and, you know, how the weather service reacted to the news of the storm and all that kind of stuff. So it's going to be really cool. It's going to be split into 3 different things talking about the same topic.
Well, that is actually very interesting to see how you're playing that out. Mm-hmm. And it would actually be something I think a lot of people would be interested in.
Oh, absolutely. We've had, the posts about those events have been shared more than anything else that I have ever shared on Facebook at any time in my life. I really think that there is a market of people that just really want to know. And the stories that go along with it, the ghosts that were left behind in the wake of the storm, they want their stories told too.
Oh, yeah.
We were told by many people when we branched off from the other company, we were like, we don't want to tell ghost stories anymore. I think we just want to focus on history. And we were told, are you crazy? The ghosts want for you to tell their story. You know, they want for somebody that's doing the research to actually let other people know what's happened and what's going on. You know, that's the only way that their memory can really truly be honored, is by people telling their story. And the more we thought about it, the more we realized that truly, really, we are very spooky people, and we really, really used to do this. And so it was crazy because while we were putting our tours together, just the historic side, there were very important pieces that we needed that Alicia couldn't find the research on because she just couldn't. But as soon as we said, all right, we're going to do ghosts, we're going to talk about the ghost stories, all that information fell right into place, and she was able to put the research where it needed to be.
Wow.
I found newspaper articles that didn't exist, apparently, in any database, in any archive. And then we said, okay, we'll go ahead and do ghost stories. The newspaper articles that I'd seen referenced before that I couldn't find, no matter how hard I looked, suddenly, there they were. Right there in this archive, falling into my lap.
Don't you love it when things fall into your lap? I know that's what happens with me a lot when it comes to this field.
Mm-hmm. Oh, absolutely. And, you know, and we're very respectful and tasteful about what we say and what we share. And looking through the history, we don't put our own personal spin on it. We actually go through the facts and we read the articles and the books and go through the archives. We love it whenever people that have ancestors that were involved in the 1900 storm in any capacity, when they reach out to us and they share their stories, their photos, they share the letters that they have, things of that nature. We love that because that gives us a human interest perspective of it. And that really goes into showing us the gravity of the situation and what they actually went through. So we love that.
It also helps combat the skeptics that we get, that every one of us in this industry gets in the crowd. You're going to have that one person that says, well, I don't believe in ghosts and you can't convince me. That's okay. Here, let me tell you this really fantastic historical story, this thing that actually happened. Truth is stranger than fiction. So even if you are going to be a naysayer, let me still entertain you with the facts of the past.
Absolutely. Right. And we've been finding that a lot of people actually don't just want to hear the ghost stories. They actually want to hear the history behind the place.
Yes.
Yes, they do. We have experienced that a lot ourselves. And so we don't try to make the stories fit with whatever event was happening we actually go straight for the story as it was. Mm-hmm. And we approach it from that angle. Now, if there are people that we know that are experiencing hauntings here on the island and they want to share their stories, we're happy to pass those stories along because, you know, oral tradition is born that way. And we have a lot of those here on the island and we love them. But they had to come from somewhere, so we try to research the history to find out where that starts.
Yeah, and see how much truth is behind it and what comes with it. Yeah, because we've run into, well, you get the oral story of history, and then you research it and find out it's been twisted a little bit more than it should have.
Absolutely, yes. We have some lovely stories. We have a story about a schoolmarm that was jumping out of windows and things like that during the storm. And, you know, a lady of her caliber probably wasn't actually doing that. But there is, in fact, a lady in the news article that did die from complications from being in the storm water. Probably not from jumping out the window and saving people like the oral tradition says, but, you know, she did exist, and we don't know her name, but, you know, she wasn't doing what everybody says she was, but she was here.
It was if it wasn't written down like that, then we don't know for sure. I mean,
yeah, over time, stories tend to change, and they get dramatized a little more.
And so we try to go back to the archives as best we can, and we find the facts that we can, and we share those.
Yeah.
I mean, we have a lovely story about the this building that where this man and his son, they came together. Like, what was that one? Edward Lee and
the Lee,
his dad?
Yeah.
Yeah, they came together right as the son was passing away, and he's part of the Civil War stories. And whenever you go over to the building that used to be the hospital, it has a very strange and unique feeling as soon as you walk in. But, you know, there's a lot of different stories that come from there about, like, this man that, you know, was laughing and saying that his father had come and he was dying. And everybody was like, well, you know, surely his time is coming. It's got to be done. And then it turned out to be his father was really across the room from him. And, you know, we try to research things like that to find out how much truth there is to it.
My favorite story that actually turned out true in the research was a story of this, actually happened in 1900, this young man who got hit by a train and decapitated. And so his headless spirit walks the train yards and the railways looking for his missing head. Now, that one, as far-fetched as it sounds, I go into the newspaper archives and I find that it was front page news. This young engineer got off of his ship. He thought he was going to just hop on a passing freight train and instead got decapitated where his head was missing. They couldn't identify the guy for several days. And it made the front page news of the Galveston Daily News for 3 days straight trying to figure out who this headless guy was.
Wow.
And then there are also other cool stories. Like, for instance, for a long time, we've been able to see the ghost ships out in the harbor, out in the water. And it's been...
Since I was little.
We've always experienced it. We've just these great big blooming sails, just, you know, it's this big black ship. And we've seen several of them, but there's just one that has always stood out through the test of time. And nobody has ever really been able to find much history on it. And then Alicia, in her research recently, came across a couple of stories.
I came across where a couple of different websites, because sometimes you hit, when you're in your research, you hit a wall and you just hit Google.
Yeah.
And I had found several different accounts, and I found where they had listed it. And in the diaries of one of the naval captains during the Civil War, this captain talks about, here in Galveston Bay, talks about the exact same ship that I have seen, that, you know, that Jenna has seen, that, you know, other friends of ours have seen over the years, out there in that water, describes it the exact same way that we were seeing it. And it had, in the diaries of a ship's captain from the Civil War, that ship had been out there with the sails all lit up. To me, it looks like Hollywood lighting, but, you know, back then they say it's just lit by this eerie white-blue light, but It's been seen since before the Civil War, and I had no idea.
Wow.
And that gives you some validation, too, that, you know, we're really not crazy. We really are seeing these things. And we're the ones that have ever experienced it. So it's really cool when things like that fall into our lap and we're able to know. And not only that, but then she found documentation that, you know, people that have been working out on the oil rigs and the cruise ships, they also have seen this particular entity out there. So
it's one ghost ship.
So it's not just us. It's there's actually documentation validating that this thing exists. It's really there.
Now, see, now I want to go look for a ghost ship.
Well, that just means you need to take a road trip and come on down.
And dolphins. And
pirates, dolphins, ghost ships, you know, haunted hotels and businesses. You can't go wrong down here. You really can't. And that's all without even considering the great people that live down here, because we have a lot of really nice people down here, and there's just so many people that are friendly and helpful. And, you know, if you're lost, people aren't just going to shrug and walk away. They'll actually walk you to your next destination. I mean, it's just that kind of vibe down here. It's really cool.
Now, see, I'm going to try that. I'm going to ask for directions just to see if someone will walk me to the next place.
Oh, they will. They will.
Now you're going to go to all the locals and you're going to be like, okay, if this lady named Becky comes down, you have to walk her.
I would never, ever have to tell anyone that, because our city is just that helpful. A lot of people down here go through the tourism certification for the ambassador program. And it's one of the things that the locals really take seriously is hospitality. Because they want for you to have a good time, because they want you to come back, because, you know, the money that we get in from tourism, that's our big draw to our island. So we want to make people happy. So everybody pretty much pitches in and does what they can to help.
Yeah, see, that sounds really cool.
Yeah, see, if you did that here, they'd turn around looking and go, can I help you? Is there a reason why you're following me?
Call the cops. There's this weird person following me.
Well, look, and the cool thing is, too, is that if you should come down and you should find that you've forgotten your bathing suit, you can go down to our haunted Walmart and pick yourself one up.
Even Walmart's haunted, huh?
Probably not by the spirits you think.
Well, have you ever seen a Walmart that closes?
No.
Our Walmart closes at midnight, regardless of the season.
Ours don't.
No, they're open 24/7.
Yeah, even Black Friday.
They keep their regular hours.
That's scary.
Yeah, I don't even go out on Black Friday.
Yeah, that's scary enough.
Well, the Walmart sits where there was an orphanage in the 1900s. The orphanage, it was completely erased by the 1900 storm. And nuns and children perished there.
There were 10 nuns that took care of 93 children, school-age children. And all but 3 boys were killed in the 1900 storm. And the orphanage and all of its outbuildings, chapel and everything, were completely wiped off the map.
Wow. And so
that Walmart was actually built on the site of where that orphanage was.
Well, I'm sure the kids like the toys, right?
Yes. They don't bother cleaning the toy department until about 9 o'clock in the morning.
I like toys.
Things. They say that there's a set of small child's footprints that's on the tile that just can't wash off, but I haven't found it yet.
But that means we're not looking. Because we always look.
All right.
Probably covered by, if it's there, it's probably covered by a shelf or something.
Probably.
But awesome. I keep looking and I keep not finding it.
That's when you start moving shelves around and you get, you know, an employee coming up going, can I help you?
Have you tried to move those shelves? They're heavy.
Well, we love your stories. We love everything you're saying about your town. We seriously, I'm like in awe over wanting to get there now.
Yeah, she keeps looking at me like, you gotta go, gotta go, gotta go.
I know we can't right now, but, you know, we're completely booked until like November. So I know we can't right now, but, you know, I'm not one to want to buy Christmas gifts anymore. So a vacation sounds really good for Christmas. What do you think?
We got a few things we need to get through first.
Oh, but yeah, you definitely have a new place on my bucket list. So thank you so much for that. He's like looking at me like, yeah, thanks.
That's because every time she mentions it, he keeps staring at me.
Mm-hmm. But before we let you go, we definitely want you to throw out once again where everyone can find you so everybody can go like you and look up your website and all that stuff.
You can find us on Facebook, Lantern Light Tours of Galveston. Our website, www.lanternlightgalveston.com.
And Twitter?
And Twitter.
Twitter is Lantern Light Galveston
Galveston Lantern Light or mm-hmm. Lantern Light Galveston?
Lantern Light Galveston. And on Instagram, it's the same thing.
Okay. Well, thank you both so much. You definitely had me very interested and definitely got me really wanting to go. So thank you for that. And we really do look forward to, you know, hopefully coming out there and meeting you guys and taking your tours.
We would love to have you.
We absolutely would. So whenever you get ready to come out, just let us know you're planning on coming this way. And that way we'll know that we need to take you out to see pirates, ghost ships, and dolphins.
Yeah, exactly. And we got to try to arrange the Disney cruise.
How about we just go on the boat and then get back off the boat?
You know.
Because Disney and money mean broke.
Let's see, they're here in January, and
I'm actually looking.
He's like, you're not helping. Well, thank you both so much. We really appreciate you taking your time tonight to come talk to us. I know Will really appreciates it a lot.
Well, we appreciate it as well. So thank you for having us.
Yeah, thank you for being on the show. It was great.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it. Thank you guys so much and have a wonderful night. And yes. Enjoy your haunted town.
All right, thank you. You too.
All right, thank you. Bye.
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 So, yeah, we got to go now.
Oh.
I'm like, we got to go. I know we literally can't go right now, but
it'll probably be closer to a year before we get out there.
Yeah, considering that we're doing a wedding renewal in May, and
yeah,
and I do want to, you know, do some type of honeymoon, so to say, after that.
You know, the first honeymoon wasn't good enough.
In all reality, the only honeymoon that we had was going to Phoenix. We went to a zoo.
Yeah, that wasn't bad for being broke.
I know, but I would like a little bit better, like Disney.
You've had enough Disney.
No, I love Disney. I can always have Disney. And we're having a Beauty and the Beast themed wedding, fitting to have Disney afterwards.
No, see, there's your Disney right there. You have the wedding Disney theme, so you're good. You're good.
Oh, well. We'll discuss that later because that will be a long drawn.
Probably one-sided. And
all I'm going to say is Disney, and you're not going to listen.
And yeah, pretty much.
I'm like, that's all I'm going to say is Disney, and you're going to be like, no. And I'm going to be like, yes.
Raina, no.
I agree. Early honeymoon, but, you know, whatever. So, yes, we will definitely try to go. We'll try our best to go to Galveston because come on, they had so much that had me going, oh, I'm so jealous.
No, I liked it. I looked it up. It's a cool place.
Yeah. I mean, amusement parks, pirates, dolphins, Disney Cruise leaves from there, haunted places. Where can you go wrong? I mean, you really can't. You notice the Disney Cruise was thrown in there, though, right?
You realize there's a lot of water there and things tend to get washed up on the beach.
Oh, gee. Thanks. I love you, too. But, you know, the good thing is you're saying this on air, so if I do turn up missing, you're going to be the first one they come to.
I said things turn up on the beach.
All right. So before we wrap up the show, we want to encourage you to go to all their websites, all their Facebook.
And the website was posted in the chat room.
Yes, but if they're not in the chat room, then how are they supposed to know that?
Then they're supposed to go to Spreaker, find the show.
Which you are just so determined to get people in the chat room.
Yes.
I know you are, but still, just look them up. They're really cool. Lantern Lights Tours of Galveston. I'm tongue-tied now. Blah. Like all of, you know, their pages, follow them, all that lovely stuff. And while you're on Facebook liking their pages or Twitter, make sure you like ours too.
Absolutely.
So we have Mysteries Explained on Facebook, Tucson Ghost Company on Facebook, Tucson Ghost Society on Facebook, and then on Twitter we're at Mysteries Radio. You have to put at Mysteries Radio because Mysteries Explained was already taken on Twitter, so I couldn't use that one. So it's at Mysteries Radio instead on Twitter.
Well, who has Mysteries Explained?
I don't know. How they dare
to, they
though,
need
huh?
to give it up.
But yeah, definitely check us out. And definitely do not forget to like us and follow us and get notifications on YouTube under Tucson Ghost Company, because we are going to start doing live, hopefully live, this Saturday night, investigations through YouTube. And if we can't do them live, then we will record them and put them on YouTube when we can
transfer it over.
Yeah, get reception and all that lovely stuff. Hopefully we get good reception at the slaughterhouse, I'm hoping.
Should.
We should. Keeping fingers crossed that we can do our first live YouTube this Saturday. And that would be at about 10:30 p.m. Arizona time, which is, what, 1:30 a.m. Eastern time. So it is going to be late. But if you go to YouTube and hit that lovely subscribe and that little bell to get the notifications, you'll know when our videos mm-hmm. are posted.
And make sure you, on your phone, you turn on your notification notice so that when you do get the bell to ring, your phone will actually let you know.
Or they could just have random ringing for no reason at all, but that's only if they live in a haunted place, most likely.
Or their phone just sucks and it's acting up and doing weird things.
Mine does that all the time, so that doesn't surprise me. But yes, and definitely check out TucsonGhostTour.com. That's where you can buy tickets for most of everything going on for us. We have the National Ghost Hunting Day, which is September 29th, that we're selling tickets for. We have the Gydesen Tour, which is October 13th. We have another Arcadia, which is October 20th. We have Spirits with Spirits, which is at Borderlands, which is October 27th. Those are on sale at our website. Now, we do have a couple events that we're doing that we aren't selling the tickets.
But if you go to our website, it
the information
you,
is yes. there and where to go. Like Fox Theater. Fox Theater is going to be through their website.
And the Center Stage is going to be through their website.
Which is one we didn't bring up. We talk about it every week. We have to throw that out there again this week. May 3rd and 4th, Center Stage Events is doing Slaughterhouse. And they are bringing Grant Wilson. I get so excited every time I say that. And Greg and Dana Newkirk. They're the ones with the Paranormal Occult Museum. And if you all don't know who Grant Wilson is, for starters, I'm sad. but he is from the show Ghost Hunters. I'm probably, you know, one of his biggest fans. I'm not a stalker, I swear, but
she says that, but
no, I'm just very thrilled to finally get to meet someone that I truly, you know, idol in the field and based Tucson Ghost Society off of what Ghost Hunters, you know, Jason and Grant was about. So it's just an honor that I'm going to finally get to meet him, because if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing. So, and we have talked to Grant in the past, and he was a really down-to-earth, nice guy. So that made me even like him more, because he was just so outgoing. And we got to talk about Disney.
Yes, you did.
So, you know, how can you not like someone that can talk about Disney with you? I'm sorry. That's like a given. You have to be able to do that. You're rolling your eyes at me. I love you too. Mm-hmm. Talk about Disney and Ghost. What else do you need in this world? I know you put up with me so much. next week, we have our guest is Girls versus Ghost. Because okay. Next week is the 30th, right? Yes.
Yes.
So next week is Girls versus Ghost. They actually have a show that they do on, oh God, I'm going to probably say it wrong. VD. Thank you. So they do that, and that's that Nick Groff network, for those who don't know. So they have their show over there. We're going to bring them on as our guests, and they're going to tell us about their show and what exactly they do and how life has been with them. Mm-hmm. So that's our guest for next week. And then, of course, we have guests all the way through October, and there's the show on the 13th that we will have to cut short, though.
Yes.
Because that is when we have to go out to Old Tucson to do the whole iHeartRadio thing, which I will try to get information about that before it happens, so you'll all know how to tune in, if it's live or if it's going to be recorded, and let you know how to find that. And we will hopefully have that information beforehand, especially if it's live. It would be good to have it beforehand. And we'll fill you all in on that one. What are you looking at right now?
Oh, the center stage event.
Okay. What are we saying about this center stage event?
Well, you have the VIP admission, which is May 3rd.
Right.
Which includes the meet and greet with your favorite celebrity guests, as you already know, Grant.
And Greg and Dana.
Then you also get to do the investigation with them, small group, crawl around in the dark, ghost hunt.
Now, what Lindsay had said is the VIP is limited to 12 people.
Yes.
And the last time I checked, she had sold, I think, over half of that already. So there's not a whole lot of the VIP left.
And you also get a complimentary celebrity autographed photo of the event with the VIP tickets. And then, of course, on the May 4th, you have the general admission. So you'll have the ghost hunt.
You still get to...
You still get to do the meet lecture. And greet, and you get the celebrity guest lecture, Q&A session.
And the investigation. It's just, that one is more people. I think that one, she said, was maybe 50 or 60. So it's not as small, it's not as intimate. But yeah, so it's going May 3rd and May 4th. It's going to be fun. I'm so excited. Yeah. Can't wait. And Slaughterhouse... Okay, not only are you getting freaking Grant Wilson and Dana and Greg, but Slaughterhouse is filled of activity. We've investigated a few times, and we're never disappointed. And we're going back this weekend. We're never disappointed with Slaughterhouse.
No, we're not.
No.
And even if nothing happened, it's still a really great building to go and hang out in for a couple hours.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's a haunted house, so fake and real. All right, hon. Well, it's time we wrap up the show tonight. Any final words for the audience?
Keep listening. We'll see you next. We'll talk to you next week. How's that sound?
They won't see you. They'll talk. Or I'll listen.
Yeah.
You'll talk. That's how it goes.
Yeah.
Anything else? That was quick and simple.
Okay. I could steal your line.
No, don't you dare.
Can't do that.
Don't you dare steal my line.
You're never.
No. Not allowed. I'm covering his mouth. All right. Yes. Thank you to all of our listeners. We do encourage you to get in the chat room because Will will keep bringing it up during the shows because he likes to see people chat in the chat room. He's obsessed with that. But if you're listening to us on Spreaker, iHeart, Spotify, thank you so much. We appreciate your support. We will be here every Thursday at 8 p.m. Eastern. And until next week, remember, you are never truly alone. Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Storm inside. Who's gonna save you?